Welcome back to Building Applications with MinStack. In this session, we shall be covering more of the services, which is actually practical. First and foremost, we have to define our socket service. And our socket service, right into our service folder. And in our socket service, we're going to define something called socket. And this service that we call socket is going to return something that registers for us the events that we want to actually track. And in this case, we want to track the donor created, donator changed, donator removed. We should be able actually to see something happening on our UI. Let's say, for example, we have 10 people using this blood group donor system. Whenever a user one tries to add a donor, all the 10 users should actually be updated in real time that a new donor has been added. This is the power of the socket IO. Things are done in real time. As you can see, we go right ahead and define the kind of events that we want to actually listen to. And then we move right to our map directive. And in our map directive, we are now going to pass the socket service that we actually defined. And after passing the socket service that we defined, we are now going to come down here in our controller, and we're going to use the socket service, and we're going to say on donor created, do ABCD, on donor changed, do for us, whatever is inside here. That means we're going to create a pin and then pin it on the map. This will be happening in all our 10 users in real time. Now let's say, for example, we have 100 users, it will also happen on 100 users in real time. This is very powerful. In case we remove a donor, we are going to trigger that the next event. This is very powerful. This is very useful. And I would urge you, when you clone this project from the repository, that is MR Onyancha, MinStack, please try it out and see its power. Try it out and see its power. Try to build it for yourself. And if you can be able to achieve this by the end of the day, you can be able to build at least a project for someone. But first and foremost, we shall go through the demo of what we've so far built over these 5 sections. By default, you click, let's say, add a donor. So far, we have a donor at least, who's called by names of put. Now, we're going to add a new donor. And in this new donor, we are going to call him the American. And I'm going to call him Peter. I'm also going to go right ahead and give him a phone number. Right there. We're going to give him an email address. Right there. Now we shall go ahead and choose for him a blood group AB. And then let's change the location so that we can have the American come from Zingoti, that is old Kampala, Mitiana. So when we use that, and then we submit, when we move this other side, by default you've seen that we've already updated the UI and added the new donor, the American Peter. Now, the American Peter has been added right there. You can always edit details of the American Peter by clicking on the link that we've given you right there. This has been all for our session.